Hello everybody and welcome to this video. I am very happy that you pleased to take interest in the self-sustaining power box that I am in the midst of designing once again. There's a big long story to this, and I'm going to tell you the story, and then I'm going to show you what this is all about and how it works. My credentials, the credentials that matter, is I have a degree in physics and an associate's degree in electronics. And the rest is all just big long story that I got to tell you. But I will tell you as short of a version as I can. Now this power box, basically what it is, it's solar panels inside of a box. You've got mirrors inside the box and you've got lights inside the box. The lights provide the current to the solar panels, which in turn provide the current to the lights, and it's self-sustaining. It's not plus one and it's not perpetual motion. It does work. I've done this several times. If you don't believe it, just stay tuned to further videos and you will see it work. I promise you that it works. This is not a scam. This works. I do not expect any donations without being able to show proven results. But now on to the story behind this. The first time that I did this with a friend of mine who is now dead. This man claimed to be an abductee of aliens. I'm also an abductee, but I didn't get the information that he got. I got different stuff. Oh wow. I just realized, I just admitted that I'm an abductee on YouTube. I've never done that before. Okay. Now that I'm done thinking about that. The long and the short of it is that back in the 80s, we used to do things all the time. We'd find stuff because we were bored. We'd find things, and my buddy would say, well, the aliens told me how to do this, and the aliens told me how to do that. So one time in his garage, we put together an engine that was very similar to what goes in a spacecraft. This took mercury, lights, mirrors, and we actually made an engine. The engines that are in the spacecraft actually work on the principle of light, and they use light as propulsion. That sounds pretty crazy. But what's really crazy is that we did this, and everybody outside the garage, when we had this on, said that the garage was going in and out of phase. In other words, you could see it, and you couldn't see it. When we finished and we shut this off, we have no idea how they knew about it, but there were certain men in black suits. There were three of them. They walked up. They said, how you doing? They had known us. They knew who we were. We knew who they were. They said, tear it apart. Never do it again. Don't talk about it. Nobody will believe you anyway. But you can't have this. You're not allowed to do it. They went on their way. We never did it again. 10 years later, we talked about it, but of course, nobody believed it. We also did what I'm talking about now with the power box. We would scavenge stuff because it's like, okay, we can use this. Well, we had some big old solar panels, and I got this idea in my head. Why doesn't this work? They say it doesn't work, but if I take this solar panel here and I put this light up to it, it works. It runs itself. I didn't run it through its complete phase. It lasts probably a half hour, and then the light itself becomes like a vampire and it sponges more current than the solar panel can produce, and it dies that fast. That was the hurdle that we had to get over. So I got this box going, and we're running the garage on this box. And this box was probably, okay, well, you know how big a piece of plywood is, right? That's how big it was, with the mirrors and the fluorescent lights And the solar panels, they were the big solar panels that go on the house. That's how big it was. So, we get this thing going. We're powering the garage. And our friends, Men in Black, whatever you want to call these guys, they showed up. They took it. They didn't even just, they took it. They said, if you ever do this again, then you're in trouble. That's the story of when it was first done. Well, now I'm in a place in my life. I'm old. I'm retired. Things are getting to the point where we need an alternative. You know, we need an alternative. We've got Mystery Electric Company that comes around, wants our money, more and more money for the power. We've got all these disasters that seem to be happening. Well, there are many disasters. It's the weather. The weather has been knocking out the power. All that kind of happy stuff. Okay. Well, this box is the answer. You hook this box up to the house, and it goes forever. You hook it up to your garage. Okay, imagine you don't have to feed electricity back to the power company. Imagine that you can do it for $5,000 instead of $20,000 to $30,000. Just imagine. Okay, how about you build a piece of property in the middle of nowhere? Has no electric going to it. You couldn't afford how much it would cost to send electric. Well, this is the answer. You would have electric. If there's a power outage, the hospitals would have electric. Power outage due to a great big snowstorm or whatever, whatever the reason is. This thing really works, and it's fairly cheap. I don't know what to call this thing, but what I'm going to do later on in this video is show you exactly how it works. And if you have a brain in your head, you can figure out where I'm going with this and where it goes from here. I don't have the money right now to build a proper box because I'm retired. That's why I asked for donations, so I can build this and I can show everyone on YouTube this is exactly how you do it and exactly how you can use it. Okay, I guess it's time now to show you the box. And then I will, the box is off at the moment, but I will show you this demo. There we go. That's inside the frame there, I think. I will show you this. Now, I will take it apart and I will show you the parts. And I'll show you exactly how it works. And by that time, you'll be ready to watch something else anyway. Just let me add here before I show you the box and start taking apart the box so I can show you how it works, how it goes together. We live in stupid times. They want to arrest people for saving rainwater. You know, taking 50-gallon containers, putting it up to the house, collecting rainwater from the gutters, and they want to throw people in jail for that. They want to tell you, no, you must buy your electric from us. No. You cannot make your own power, because if you do that, you must give us back some power and we will pay you for it, but we won't pay you what we charge you. There's so many things you're not allowed to do now in a lot of states, and it's pretty stupid and it's pretty ridiculous. I mean, the military right now has motorcycles that run from that. The military has electric motorcycles. I know this to be a fact. These electric motorcycles recharge their batteries from the tires spinning. Every time the motorcycle goes down the road, the wheels spin, it charges up the batteries, and it just keeps on going. Well, it's the same damn thing that I'm talking about with this light box. And now on to the main reason why you're here.
All right, first let me, all I have to do is just unscrew the sides. Just one side, that's all I have to do. And then I take it apart. You'll see how I take this apart. Do it as fast as I can here. This is the inside of the box. I am using solar lights at the moment, modified. I have this light panel here. This light panel goes to this deal right here. These panels, let me pull this back. These panels are what this runs off of, which in turn runs this. Now what needs changed is this light board right here needs to be infrared. This thing runs for 7 days and then it dies. There's two reasons that it dies. Alright, there's two reasons that it dies. One reason is that the lights that I just pointed out to you need to be infrared so that they produce more power, more wattage, going into the panels than is sent out. That is the main problem right now. And that's why they need to be infrared. The LEDs that are, like, for example, inside your remote control are the LEDs that need to be used here. The light bounces off the mirror on top. You saw me take the mirror off. When the light bounces off the mirror, it hits the solar panels. It's that simple. The solar panels charge the batteries and it's a continuous loop. Now, let me show you this. This is the other deal. This is basically in this box. Why is my pencil? I'm showing you the one. Basically in this box right here, we have two of these. One is to make everything work. The other one is just to show you that it works from the outside. When this dies right here, where my pencil is pointing to, when this deal dies, the other one dies pretty much the same time. It means it's not producing enough current anymore to charge the batteries and they die. Now, I don't know any battery that will last, rechargeable or not, that will last 7 days. They last 12, 13, 14 hours and then they die. That's just the way that it is. If you don't believe me, put new batteries in a flashlight, leave the flashlight on. I guarantee you by morning that flashlight will be dead. So, with that being said, I've got this string right here of Christmas lights. And that doesn't take a whole lot of current. And that string of Christmas lights shows that everything is working. Here's the switch right here. to turn it on. As you see, I turned the LEDs on. Oh man, this doesn't work very well, does it? But the LEDs are on. Let me turn them off. See. All right. There's not much else to it than that. Let me give you another shot so you can see this thing. Yeah, you can see my computer. Alright, can you grasp that? Can anybody out there grasp what I'm doing? I'm telling you, 7 days, if you make this thing work better, 7 days will turn into 7 years. Alright, there's something you need to know. Rechargeable batteries, after a while, cannot hold a charge, so the batteries die. Thus, it's not perpetual motion. Thus, it's not plus one. There's two factors here that make it so it's not plus one or perpetual motion. There's no way. Not this deal. The other thing is that my solar panels, they're all loose inside this deal. I have to glue them down because the Velcro is not working, it's not sticking. One of the reasons that this thing fails is that the panels come loose from the Velcro and they fall off. I don't know what else. I don't know what to do with that at the moment, other than find some kind of glue that'll work. I'm pretty convinced that if I get the solar panels to stay in place, that this box will last for 30 days. Could you imagine, all right, Hurricane Katrina, where there was no power in New Orleans for at least a month anywhere, but you had this box kept in your basement and your house survived. Guess what? You have power. And you can do what nobody else can. Everybody's going to be, hey man, they got power, let's go over there and cook our food. That sort of thing. It also brings up, well, if you're the only one that has power within 10 block radius, people are going to be showing up at your house that you might not want there. That's the other thing to consider. All right, this part of the project video is, I gotta turn this off and start it again. Alright, do you get a better way of looking at it there for a second? Let me move this up. Okay, thank you for taking the time to watch this. The other part that I didn't show you, I'm going to show you now, is that all solar panels, the big hurdle with using these solar lights that come out of your front yard, because these are old, and the dogs got a hold of them, and they ate up the casing and everything. It's like, okay, I got scrap, I'm gonna see what I can do. Then I remembered about this project, so I put it back together. Well, there's something you have to do. You see these pieces right here. The big square solar panels that come in the solar lights already have these inside the solar panel, and you can't use them. That's why I have the deal I do. I cut these off. This tells it when it's light and when it's dark. Because during the light, it's charging. The solar panels are charging the batteries and the lights will not work. So you have to cut these off. And when you cut these off, real simple to do, when you cut these off, the light's on constantly, charging the solar panel, and it's the circle. Anyway, I know you're getting bored with this. Thank you for watching. Any questions,
go to the forum below. The URL is in the stuff posted below this video. You can donate. You can keep track of what is going on with this project and any other projects that are on the site. This is the best I can do at the moment. Thank you for watching. Oh, and when you do get to the forum is actually for the business that I am attempting to do, which is putting lights on motorcycles or cars or trucks or, you know, whatever to enhance the bike. Yeah. So anyhow, thank you.